The emphasis for the next several videos will be with the idea of random variables and probability distributions. So, like usual, let's take a look at the overall learning objectives. What is it we want to get out of these next five or six videos, whatever it turns out to be? First of all, we want to be able to identify a discrete and continuous random variable. You actually know how to do this, you just don't realize it yet. We've already are determined or defined discrete and continuous variables. So now all we're really going to do is add this idea of a random variable. What does that actually mean? So we want to be able to construct a probability distribution for a discrete random variable and compute the mean, variance, and standard deviation for a discrete random variable. So let's start off with the idea of just what is a random variable. By definition, a random variable is a variable that's assigned to an item of interest. See, that's a variable, right? In a statistical study such that the values that it can assume either result a very chance or random event. So up until this point right here, all of this was just the same definition we've been using for variables. In reality, when we've been talking about variables prior to this, we've really been talking about random variables, just has not introduced that term yet. So suppose I do a study and I randomly select 30 people, say 30 students, to ask their opinion on some type of political poll. Well, one of the variables may be their gender, age, perhaps, political party, who they associate them with, and perhaps income. And let's say another one, vote. So I'm going to ask, who are you going to vote for in this upcoming election? Well, each and every one of these is now a random variable because I started this off saying I was going to take a random sample of, I think I said 30. If not, it is now. So because it's a random sample of 30, this first person that I take, perhaps they're a male, so I record an M. The fact that they're a male, that came from a random process, that being the random sample. In reality, 99.99%, if not all the variables that we deal with in this course, are actually random variables because the values that they take on, the values that we assign to them, is a result of a random sample or some type of random process. Now, discrete versus continuous random variables. We've already talked about the idea of a discrete variable, and this doesn't change. So I'm going to review this quickly here. Suppose we have, as an example, the number of, say, broken eggs. Whoops, broken eggs in a carton. So the variable may simply be broken. That may be what we're going to record. Okay, is this discrete or continuous? Well, if the process, first of all, that we went randomly selected these cartons to begin with was some type of random process, then here we are, random variable. But clearly this is discrete because could you have zero broken eggs? Yes. Could you have one broken egg? Yes. Could you have something in between here? Could you have one and a half broken eggs? No, not possible. So it's discrete. It naturally ends. In nature, it ends someplace. That's not the same as your ability to measure. Now, suppose we did somebody's height. Well, again, if this person that we're talking about was randomly selected through some type of random process, then their height would, in fact, be a random variable. So, height, any type of length, is considered to be continuous. I may claim that I'm 5'7" tall. Is it really possible that I'm, oops, let me see here. There we go. That I'm 5'6.9" tall? Well, of course. Could it be that I'm actually 5'6.99" tall? Could it be that I'm 5'6.99999" tall? Can I play this forever and get infinitely close to 7? Yes. Now, obviously, at some point, very quickly, I'm going to lose my ability to actually measure this, to physically do it. But that has nothing to do with what really happens in nature. So this would be, height would be a continuous random variable because of this sort of game that we can play. And again, this is just a review from a prior chapter. So I did the exact same thing in the prior chapter. We talked about discrete continuous variables. Now all I'm adding is this idea of random, that whatever it is that we're measuring, the fact we're measuring that item was a result of some type of random process or by chance.